Welcome everybody. A lot of people are expected, but I think the heat of London has taken them and slowed them down. It is also football. It is a very poor. Cyprus is like a football game. We don't know where we are sometimes, but I hope that they shall score well. As I said, welcome. The formal welcomes will be done by Peter and Alicia, so I address nobody specifically, but that will follow. All I want to say is a big thank you to our three guests from Cyprus, who left a nice Nicosia, who has a beautiful breeze at this time of the night.
Absolutely.
To come to this hot weather unbearable. Also, I really want to extend a very big thank you to Mr. Stefanos Stefanou, who has honored us again this year and left all the problems in Cyprus with foreign powers and, worst of all, with the eternal competition and struggle. I don't wish to be in your shoes, but again, I wish you luck.
Thank you.
Now, I will ask Alicia to extend a welcome on behalf of the university.
I don't know if I can follow that. I think that was a very good welcome. Again, we just wanted to say thank you very much to our honoured guests for coming here tonight. And I know a lot of you made a lot of trouble to come here, even coming from Cyprus. Some of our other guests for our conference tomorrow. I just wanted to welcome you to the University, London Metropolitan University, and specifically to the Cyprus Centre at London Metropolitan University. We've been very actively involved in promoting Cyprus and Cyprus issues since 1988, when John Charalambous here started the Cyprus Centre and started different activities in promoting Cyprus at the university in different ways, including conferences and lectures and all sorts of events, including exhibitions, the BBC Good Food Show, all sorts of different things. So we try to be as prolific as possible and promote both Cyprus and the university where we can. And I won't go on too much about the Cyprus Centre, because you have really come here to listen to Mr. Stefanou speak. So I'll pass you over to Peter Droussiotis, who will formally introduce Mr. Stefanou.
Thank you very much, Alicia. Thank you, John.
I cannot record this.
Oh, I will be here. Okay. Thank you very much, John and Alicia. Your Excellency, Cyprus High Commissioner, this is High Commissioner, my good friend Stephanie, distinguished guests, my very good friend, the Consul General of the Republic of Greece, and other representatives of the Cyprus High Commissioner, Dr. Nicholas Haruna, the Director of the Cyprus Airways in London. And all of the other distinguished guests, including Dimitris Sagiou-Yirou, Director of the Hellenic Center, the General the Secretary of ACEL in Britain, and others, you're all very welcome. I, on behalf of the Federation and all of us here, the first thing I need to do is thank and the London Metropolitan University for hosting this event tonight. And I have to thank Dr. Alicia Christodoulou and Chrysostomou, sorry, and Professor John Charalambous, a long-term collaborator of mine and Episteme as well, for making the arrangements and for chairing the meeting that will take place. I want to thank Stefanos for making a special trip to be here with us tonight. He is extremely busy. There's a lot happening on the island, as you know. And he has made a special effort to be here with us. I'm grateful for that. He will also be here tomorrow morning at the opening session of the conference that will take place at the university. I've known Stefanos for a number of years now, and I would say that without wishing to embarrassing, but he's probably one of the brightest stars in Cyprus. You know, he really does represent a new generation of politicians on the island, and I'm delighted that he has made this connection with our community, and he has been a regular visitor to London, and I'm really grateful, you know, that he made the effort to be here with us tonight. I extend a particularly warm welcome to our Turkish Cypriot friends who are here with us this evening. And I want to say to both communities in the United Kingdom that we need to do more jointly. We need to work together in this country to celebrate the values which unite us, to celebrate the values which unite all Cypriots who want to see a free, peaceful, reunited and truly independent island. It isn't, of course, our duty or our obligation or our role to seek to negotiate the settlement in relation to Cyprus in the United Kingdom. That is for the Cypriots on the island to do. But I believe that we do have a very significant contribution to make intellectually and otherwise. And we can contribute in what is a benign environment in this country without the pressures that exist on the island, particularly in the north, in the occupied area of Cyprus. Events such as this and the conference that will take place tomorrow, which allow for patient, intelligent discussion, as well as by communal involvement and interaction, need to multiply if we are to overcome the barriers that exist to joint thinking and joint working by the two communities, both here and on the island itself. And it is through such joint work, combined with international pressure and support, that the huge obstacle that Turkey represents to a just and lasting settlement on the island can be managed and finally overcome. I have no doubt that Stefanos will give us a decisive and informative lecture, and I look forward to listening to what he has to say. I'm sure there will be opportunity for questions and answers as well. And I look forward to seeing many of you at the conference tomorrow. Thank you very much.